Welcome back to our private pilot series. In this video, we are diving into a crucial aspect of flight, drag. By the end of this video, you will know what drag is, how shapes influence drag, types of drag such as induced drag and parasite drag, understand the relationship between speed, drag, and the efficiency of flight. Whether you're a seasoned aviator or just starting your journey, understanding drag is essential for mastering the art of flying. So let's get started. Firstly, what is drag? Imagine walking against a strong wind. The resistance you feel from the wind is akin to the friction, or what we call in aviation, drag, and it intensifies with speed. You may have experienced friction or drag when rolling a ball on carpet compared to a smooth floor, showcasing the impact of surface friction. In simple terms, drag is the force that opposes an aircraft's forward motion through the air. It's like the resistance you feel when sticking your hand out of a moving car. But in aviation, it plays a pivotal role in the four forces of flight: lift, weight, thrust, and of course, drag. In aviation, we often associate friction with drag. The shape of an object significantly influences the drag it experiences. Envision a flat plate moving against an airflow. It generates noticeable turbulence, representing drag. This turbulence is akin to the resistance you feel when your hand is flat against the wind in a car. However, by enclosing this plate within a sphere, drag is considerably reduced. Now, elongating the sphere on its backside into a pointed shape creates an aerodynamic form that further minimizes drag. This stretched and tapered ball is commonly known as aerofoil. It's like turning your hand sideways to diminish resistance and enhance aerodynamic efficiency. Why is drag essential in aviation? And what is the significance of overcoming it? Well, drag is possibly the most important force of the four forces, serving a dual purpose. Firstly, it allows us to get the aircraft off the ground and into the sky, providing the necessary resistance against the air for lift. Secondly, once airborne, drag becomes instrumental in controlling the aircraft's speed and facilitating safe descent. Without drag, not only would achieving liftoff be challenging, but you'd also find yourself soaring through the sky without the means to effectively control or slow down the aircraft when needed, lacking the brakes essential for a safe and controlled flight. Equally, effectively overcoming drag is a key to embarking on long journeys with minimal energy consumption. Imagine drag as being the invisible force that pushes back against an aircraft's forward motion. To maximize fuel efficiency, aircraft are meticulously designed with streamlined and aerodynamic shapes, reducing the overall drag they encounter. Pilots, in turn, strategically navigate the delicate balance between speed and drag, aiming for the sweet spot on the drag curve, where energy consumption is minimized. This efficient management not only makes air travel cost-effective, but also aligns with our commitment to environmental sustainability. It underscores the crucial synergy between aeronautical engineering and pilot decision-making, ensuring that our flights are not only fuel efficient, but economically viable and eco-friendly. So in a sense, overcoming drag isn't just a technical necessity. It's a path to a greener and more economically sustainable future in aviation. Now let's explore the distinct types of drag that aircraft encounter during flight. Drag can be broadly categorized into two main types: induced drag and parasite drag. Induced drag is precisely what its name suggests. It is induced by factors associated with lift. This specific type of drag is a consequence of the production of lift, exemplified by phenomena such as wingtip vortices and wake turbulence. Picture it as the price we pay for generating the lift necessary for flight. On the flip side, we have parasite drag, which is primarily attributed to surface friction. This type of drag is further broken down into three components: skin friction drag, interference drag, and foam drag. each component contributes uniquely to the overall drag equation. Arising from the friction between the aircraft's surface and the surrounding air, skin friction drag is influenced by the smoothness or roughness of the aircraft's skin. Smoother surfaces experience less skin friction drag, enhancing overall aerodynamic efficiency. Interference drag occurs when different components of the aircraft, such as wingtip and fuselage, interact with each other, causing disturbances in the airflow. Interference drag highlights the importance of careful design to minimize the interactions and optimize aerodynamic performance. Form drag or pressure drag arises from the aircraft's shape, influenced by its overall contour, cross-sectional area, and frontal shape, including elements like rivets, antenna, and fixed wheels. Designing the aircraft with streamlined features is crucial to mitigate form drag. As we traverse the skies, pilots navigate the intricacies of the drag curve, a graphical depiction revealing the relationship between drag and speed. This curve is pivotal in unraveling the interplay between two major components, induced and parasite drag. Induced drag, a consequence of lift production, decreases with speed. It's driven by factors like wingtip vortices and wake turbulence. Simultaneously, parasite drag, comprising skin friction, interference, and form drag, increases exponentially with speed. As speed escalates, the total drag experiences a noteworthy evolution. Initially at lower speeds, induced drag dominates the total drag. However, as speed increases, parasite drag becomes more prominent, eventually surpassing induced drag. Understanding this curve is paramount for pilots, as it unveils a crucial concept: the speed at which total drag is at its minimum. Pilots refer to this specific speed as the best glide speed. It represents the point of equilibrium where the decrease in induced drag balances the increase in parasite drag, resulting in the lowest overall drag. In the event of an engine failure, pilots utilize this best glide speed to maximize the aircraft's gliding distance. Gliding at this speed allows the aircraft to cover the maximum horizontal distance for a given altitude, providing pilots with valuable time and options to assess and address the situation. In summary, the drag curve serves as a guide for pilots, helping them optimize fuel efficiency, maintain control, and employ strategic techniques such as best glide speed to enhance safety and decision making during different phases of flight. And there you have it, a simplified overview of drag in aviation, from the basic definition to real-world examples and different types of drag. I hope this video has enhanced your understanding. Why not put your newfound knowledge to the test? Tackle the questions in the description below for a fun way to assess what you have learned. It's also super helpful for tests you might have if you're training to be a pilot. As always, keep learning, keep flying, and stay tuned for more exciting content in our Private Pilot series. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up to support the channel. Share it with your friends keen on aviation, and drop your thoughts or topic suggestions in the comments below. Until next time, happy flying.